a warm welcome to Copenhagen and to the opening of the United Nations Climate Change Conference 2009.
The largest, most important UN climate change conference in history opened Monday, December 7, with organizers warning diplomats from 192 nations that this could be the last best chance for a deal to protect the world from calamitous global warming.
The science has never been clearer. The solutions have never been more abundant. Political will has never been stronger. And let me warn you, political will never be stronger. This is our chance. If we miss this one, it could take years before we get a new and better one, if we ever did.
The two-week conference convened in an upbeat mood after a series of promises by rich and emerging economies to curb their greenhouse gases. Still, major issues have yet to be resolved. At stake is a deal that aims to wean the world from fossil fuels and other pollutants to greener sources of energy, and to transfer hundreds of billions of dollars from rich to poor countries every year over decades to help them adapt to climate change. Scientists say without such an agreement, the Earth will face the consequences of ever-rising temperatures. With the commitments remaining short of scientists' demand, the pressure was on major emitters for bigger cuts.
In these historic moments, let us all see above our particular interests, and during negotiations, let us always keep in mind the greater good.
Conference President Kjell Hedegaard say the key to an agreement is finding a way to raise and channel public and private financing to poor countries for years to come to help them fight the effects of climate change.
No matter how we turn and toss it, if we are to become 9 billion people on planet Earth by the middle of this century, then we better start now to find more intelligent ways of creating our growth. And I think that even skeptics must acknowledge that that is a tremendous challenge. So whether you want to discuss things like that and leaked emails, I think we should take care not to be derailed here, because the matter is that we need to act for numerous reasons. And the longer we postpone action, the more severe it's going to be, and the more severe also the economic consequences.
The conference opened with video clips of children from around the globe urging delegates to help them grow up without facing catastrophic warming. On the sidelines, climate activists competed for attention with campaigns to raise awareness of deforestation, clean energy, and low-carbon growth. A 24-year-old from Fiji broke down in tears as she handed the petition from 10 million people asking negotiators at Copenhagen to come up with a deal to save islands like hers.
We need a deal that is fair to the poorest people and nations that have had little or nothing to do with the issue, but that will be affected the most. We need a deal that secures a safe planet for all peoples and nations. We need a deal that is fair, ambitious, and legally binding.
Well, there are many countries, including the G8, the G8 plus 5, the European Union, that have committed to a maximum 2-degree temperature increase. But what the small island nations are telling us here is that for anything above a 1.5% increase would be a suicide pact for them, because it would result in their nations disappearing. And part of the purpose of the negotiations over the next 2 weeks is going to be to see how countries can reach common ground on that very difficult issue.
Rajendra Pachauri, head of the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, or IPCC, defended climate research in the face of controversy over emails pilfered from a British university. Global warming skeptics say the correspondence shows that scientists have been conspiring to hide evidence that does not fit their theories.
The recent incident of stealing the emails of scientists at the University of East Anglia shows that some would go to the extent of carrying out illegal acts, perhaps in an attempt to discredit the IPCC.
Among the decisions is a proposed fund of US $10 billion each year for the next 3 years to help poor countries create climate change strategies. After that, hundreds of billions of dollars will be needed every year to set the world on a new energy path and adapt to new climates.
The time for formal statements is over. The time for restating well-known positions is past. The time has come to reach out to each other. I urge you to build on your achievements. Take up the work that has already been done and turn it into real action.
A study released by the UN Environment Programme on Sunday indicated that pledges by industrial countries and major emerging nations fell just short of reductions of greenhouse gas emissions. The scientists have said are needed to keep average temperatures from rising more than 2 degrees Celsius by the end of the century. TITV Weekly.